are some top tips to writing your story. Tip number one, everyone has a story to tell. Really commonly, what we hear is people saying, oh, I don't have a story, when you really do. When it comes to the neighbourhood, we're looking for personal stories, and you are the master of that. You know yourself, you know your stories, and that's what we want to hear. Now, our topic, as you know, is home. And to get yourself going, you might want to take a notebook and answer some of these questions just to get those creative juices flowing. Some of those questions might be, what does home mean to you? What smells remind you of home? Where in Albury Wodonga do you feel most at home? And if, like me, you're not from here, what have you left behind in another home? Just thinking about some of those questions may bring you to some ideas as to what your story might be about. Tip number two. It's really important to ask yourself, what is my story about? Sometimes we can get lots of ideas and we try and put all of that into one story. I know that's something I definitely do. But within the neighbourhood, we don't have lots of time and we don't have lots of space to share our stories. So it's really important we know what our story is about and we're clear about what we are telling. Tip number three, start with some dot points. It's a good idea, now that you know what your story is about, is to create a thought bubble or some dot points where you can write down all of your memories and thoughts and feelings around the story you're going to tell. That way it becomes really clear to visually see the points that you want to include in your story and the details that don't need to be there. It's also really good because now you can start thinking about the structure and moving those dot points around to think about the structuring and the ordering of your story. Tip number four. We love description, but it's important not to add everything and the kitchen sink in. I know that people listening to me say this will smile because it is absolutely something that I do. So really think about when you're writing your story, are there sentences of description there that don't need to be there? Or are there lots of words that can be edited? How do you write straight to the point? And really think about the important moments we describe rather than describing everything. Tip number five. And this is a really important one, and it's writing from your heart. There's a really big difference between stories that are lots of information and lots of different facts versus stories that you can tell really come from someone's heart and give us a sense of that person and of that setting. In the neighbourhood, we really want to get to know our neighbours, and in order to do that, we want to get a feel and a sense of the person who's writing the story. So make sure you put a bit of yourself in there. And here is a bonus tip for you as well. When your story's at a good place, ask a friend or a family member to read through it. Then they can check, see if there's any errors, but also make sure that they understand the story. So there are